Let's do some examples dividing fractions. Let's say that I have -5/6 divided by 3/4, divided by +3/4. Well, we've already talked about when you divide by something, it's the exact same thing as multiplying by its reciprocal. So this is going to be the exact same thing as -5/6 times the reciprocal of 3/4, which is 4/3. I'm just swapping the numerator and the denominator. So it's going to be 4/3. And we've already seen lots of examples multiplying fractions. This is going to be the numerators times each other. So we're going to multiply -5 times 4. I'll give the negative sign to the 5 there. So -5 times 4. Let me do 4 in that yellow color. And then the denominator is 6 times 3. 6 times 3. Now in the numerator here, you see we have a negative number. You might already know that 5 times 4 is 20. And you just have to remember that, look, we're multiplying a negative times a positive. We're essentially going to have -5 four times. So -5 + -5 + -5 + -5 is -20. So the numerator here is -20. And the denominator here is 18. So we get 20/18, but we can simplify this. Both the numerator and the denominator, they're both divisible by 2. So let's divide them both by 2. So give myself a little more space. So if we divide both the numerator and the denominator by 2, just to simplify this, and I pick 2 because that's the largest number that goes into both of these. That's the greatest common divisor of 20 and 18. 20 divided by 2 is 10, and 18 divided by 2 is 9. So -5/6 divided by 3/4 is, I have to be very careful here. It's -10/9. Just how we always learned. If you have a negative divided by a positive, if the signs are different, then you're going to get a negative value. Let's do another example. Let's say that I have -4 divided by -1/2. -1/2. So using the exact logic that we just said, we said, hey, look, dividing by something is equivalent to multiplying by its reciprocal. So this is going to be equal to -4. And instead of writing as -4, let me just write it as a fraction so that we are clear what its numerator is and what its denominator is. So -4 is the exact same thing as -4/1. And we're going to multiply that times the reciprocal of -1/2. The reciprocal of -1/2 is -2/1. -2/1. You could view it as -2/1, or you could view it as +2/-1, or you could view it as -2. Either way, these are all the same value. And now we're ready to multiply. Notice, all I did here, I rewrote the -4 just as -4/1. -4/1 is -4. And here, for the -1/2, since I'm multiplying now, I'm multiplying by its reciprocal. I've swapped the denominator and the numerator. What was the denominator is now the numerator. What was the numerator is now the denominator. And I'm ready to multiply. This is going to be equal to, I gave both the negative signs to the numerator, so it's going to be -4 times -2 in the numerator. And then in the denominator, it's going to be 1 times 1. Let me write that down. 1 times 1. And so this gives us, so we have a -4 times a -2. So it's a negative times a negative. So we're going to get a positive value here. And 4 times 2 is 8. So this is a +8/1. And 8 divided by 1 is just equal to 8.